Hi, I'm Coach Leslie.
And I'm Coach Andrea, and welcome to CLA Fitness Core Routine.
Core is something we are never done with, so we're going to give you 7 exercises to work on that today.
These are all pretty basic, but that doesn't mean they're not important. Make sure you're using good form and do what you can. If you have a hard time holding correct form, just back off and come right back to it. Take a bit of a break. That's fine. This is a pretty short routine. That's okay.
And it's one we can do anywhere. So if you're traveling or out and about, don't ever think it's too basic.
Nope.
That's it.
Let's get started. Let's get started, team. I'm so goofy.
All right, we're going to start with a crunch, and we're going to do it 3 different ways. We're going to start with 10 crunches straight up, then we're going to go 10 to our left and 10 to our right. And before we do anything, you want to make sure you're kind of pulling your belly button in, bracing that core, hands are behind your head, and you're going to crunch up. You want to push your head back into your hands, and that will help keep your neck relaxed.
Don't forget to breathe.
We're going to do one more this way. Now we're going to take it to our left. It's more about bringing your shoulder towards your knee.
Think about leading with your shoulder too, not necessarily with your elbow. This doesn't need to be a big movement to be effective.
Good, and let's switch to the other side. Three more. Good job. All right, there is our first one. Now we're going to take you to a plank.
Bend on over.
Now you can do a plank from your knees or from your feet, whichever is appropriate for you. And you can do it either on your forearms or from your hands. I'm going to do it on my forearms.
I haven't quite decided yet.
All right.
I'll show it from the knees.
We are going to get started.
Your body should be in a straight line. Make sure your butt is down or not too far down that your arch in your back. Continue to breathe.
Think about squeezing those glutes and squeezing your abs.
Basically squeeze everything.
Yes, but try to relax your neck.
The shoulders down, right?
Mm-hmm. Ten more seconds. Keep breathing. Good job. All right. And on to a side plank.
I'm going to do it for my knees.
And I'm going to do it for my feet. With this one, you want to make sure your elbow and shoulder are directly in a line. It's really easy to go up and have your shoulder kind of overextended, which is a little hard on your shoulder. All right, here we go.
Your body should be in a straight line. Often you see people looking at strange places. Keep your head in alignment.
You can keep your hand on your hip. You can put your hand up. Whatever feels comfortable.
Oh yeah, you're still breathing, right?
Yes, that.
Which sides?
All right. And here we go. Remember to keep your core engaged. It's easy to let your mind wander.
What? What were you talking about? it's perfectly okay to have the TV going on in the background is what I say with these sorts of things,
yes.
Right?
A little distraction doesn't hurt.
Exactly.
Five more seconds. Good job. Okay, now we are going on to a Superman. Maybe. How long are we doing this
one? It says a minute.
All right, a minute it is. Here we go. Here again, you want to keep everything kind of in alignment.
Which means you're actually looking down at the mat rather than up or down.
Right.
Sorry if you miss any action on your TV program, but this is the way it goes. If it's too much to have your arms out here, you can bring them down to your sides a bit. That makes it a little easier. You can also just lift your arms or your legs.
Breathing. You really notice you're not very far off the ground, and that's fine.
Yeah, not overarching.
No. We got 10 more seconds.
This is another one where you keep everything tight, except your shoulders and your neck.
Right, good. And you're done. Nice job. All right,
good bugs.
Yes, we're going to go on your back for this one.
All right, next we're going to do dead bugs. So we're on our back. Can you time it?
I can time it.
Okay. Legs up to tabletop and your arms are up. Brace your core and we're going to slowly extend one arm and one leg slowly. You're going to continue to breathe into your belly through this. Extend the other side.
Make sure your back is staying nice and flat.
And if it doesn't, just don't go as far out. You can keep your leg up and your arm up. Or you can just extend your leg or your arm. And we're continuing to breathe.
Not quite. Five more seconds.
Okay, we got it. We got it. That's it, right? Oh, okay.
That's it. All right. We're going to go back on our backs for a glute scoot.
Oh, this is awesome. This is a good side
exercise. So you can do it either with tabletop or feet straight up. And we're going to time it. You're going to lift your hips to one side. And then scooch to the other side.
It looks kind of goofy. It feels a little goofy, but you'll feel it on your sides.
This is one that can jump out and bite you tomorrow, too.
Keeping your neck relaxed.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. This becomes too much, just take a break and come back to it.
Got 10 more seconds. Good job.
Ooh, thanks. Oh, bird talk.
Ooh,
all right,
yes. You're already on number 7. All right. Your hands and knees are kind of shoulder width apart. And make sure those wrists are under those shoulders. You're going to extend one arm and opposite leg. And the key here is to not be arching your back.
and also be stabilizing that hip that's staying down. You don't want to be leaning way off to one side.
Or going through this so quickly that you miss the point of the exercise. It is very slow and controlled.
And you notice the movement's out of your hips, it's not in your back.
And if that means you're not extending quite as far, that's okay.
Good job. All right. Well done.
Okay. Thanks for joining us. And don't forget to like us on Facebook and Instagram and go on and subscribe to our YouTube channel. That'd be great. See you next time.
Bye.
B2. Do we have B1? Mm-hmm. I mean, we're not saying B, we're just saying core routine.